Jimmy of Lagos. I come on.
HOT on the beat. Welcome back to Brandy Circle. It's Oyinade here, well, Oyinade Brandy. And today on Brandy Circle, I'm going to be doing something like kind of different-ish. Not really different, but whatever. I'm going to be talking about like relationships and if it's really worth it. If like you should bother putting your emotion into something like that, like you kind of get me. I'm going to try to make this as relatable as possible. Like, I mean, I'm going to like share a little bit of experiences, nothing really deep. Like I told my Snapchat family, the world isn't ready. The world isn't ready for my story time yet. My story, the world isn't ready for it. So basically, I'm just going to be talking about like things I have kind of experienced, things I've seen, things I've been told, right? And yeah. I'm going to make this as fun as possible and as homely as possible, as you can see. And then, firstly, I'm going to talk about my giveaway. So I'm doing another giveaway. I want to be like, in the spirit of Christmas, right, I want to give away something like really, really big, something really big to my subscribers. But first, the first thing is I have to get up to like 200 subscribers before I give away anything. Like, so you guys, invite your friends, tell your friends to subscribe to my channel. If I go up to 200 subscribers before the end of the year, I'm going to give away like whatever it is. I mean, I'm in 191 right now, so it shouldn't be too hard to get up to 200, right? So I'm giving away something really big. I'm not going to say what it is until my next video. Yeah. So anticipate. Okay, so let's get right to it. So today I'm going to be talking, like I said before in the intro, like I'm going to be talking about like relationships. Like why bother? I mean, why bother? I mean, it works for like most people, some people. It works for some people, but like, should you actually like go into it? Like, should you actually put your emotions, like put your time and everything into someone else? We'll find out. Okay, so like, I really don't have a problem with like relationships, like to be honest at all. I have no problem. I have no problem, but my problem, like my main problem is why people actually go into relationships. Like people go into relationships for the wrongest reasons, like which is actually like terrible. You shouldn't go into relationships for like reasons I'm going to list like now. So basically, you shouldn't go into a relationship because you feel the person is such a good person. Like he's such a good guy or she's such a good girl. Like he hasn't done anything wrong, so why not? Like he's so good to me, so why not? Those are reasons that you have to see past. Like you have to see past, oh, he's such a good person, this and that. I mean, the same person you're going to into a relationship with today can be a good person today, and tomorrow the person is going to switch up on you. Are you going to leave the person when the person switches up on you, or you're going to actually fight and try to be with that person? You don't know. I mean, like that's not like a very good reason to be in a relationship. Okay. If you understand what I'm saying, like, do you think it's rewarding, or do you think it's a good thing to stay in something or to be in something with someone else? Not because you love the person or not because you care about the person, but only because the person has no transgressions. Like, it's not advisable to be in a relationship with someone because of either physical features or stuff like that. I mean, you have to see past those things. You have to see past things like that. You have to actually care about someone to be with the person. Because people do mess up. People are going to mess up. People are going to hurt you. The person you actually supposedly are with, the person can hurt you. The person can do something you won't like. If you actually don't care about the person, you're not going to think twice before you leave. And if you keep doing that, you're not going to be just one relationship, two relationships, three relationships. I mean, people have like 10, people have been like 10 bad relationships and they still don't learn. Okay, another reason why I feel people go into relationships is because they don't want to hurt the other person. I don't want to hurt him. I don't want to hurt her. That's what they always say. Oh, I don't want to hurt her. I don't want to hurt her. But to be honest, I've learned this lesson myself. This is when you start pitying someone or wondering if they'll move on without you. This is so egotistic because you're feeling like you the person's life revolves around you, which is not always so. Basically, like, someone can actually do without you if you think about it, but like, we always feel, oh, I don't want to hurt him. Yes, actually, the person can get hurt, but the person is going to move on. Are you going to tie yourself down to something that isn't working just because you don't want to hurt the person? I mean, it should be in a relationship. Relationship should be about what you actually feel. Like, it should be what you feel. And like, if you keep basing everything on what the other person feels, they're not going to move on. They're not going to be happy ever. The third reason why people go into like relationships is because they do not want to be alone. This is a very, very big one. This is one I have faced. This is one people around me have faced. This is something that is very serious. I mean, it's more than just the physical, like now we're talking about psychological feelings. I mean, some people are like monophobic. This is like, it means that they have the fear of being alone. Not being alone like physically, not like, okay, they cannot stay in a room alone or something like that. It means being alone on the inside, like not having someone to be there for them. This is something people have to work on. It's more than just like, oh, okay, I'm scared of staying in my room alone, or I'm scared of sleeping alone. So like, it's more than that. This is something that people have to actually see. You probably have to see a psychologist for this. I don't know. Some people, like, it gets so bad, like people get anxiety problems and stuff because they fear being alone. I don't want to be alone. This one is like super popular. But then, to be honest, you can actually be alone. You don't have to be in a relationship to be happy. The thing is that you have to stay out of relationships for a period of time. You have to work on yourself, know the kind of person that you are. Don't base the kind of person you are on the kind of person your partner wants you to be. You have to learn to work by yourself. You have to learn to discover yourself. You're afraid of being alone. It might not be a mere excuse actually, but then you can work on it. This is what I feel. I feel you can work on it. Like, you need to stay out of relationships. Like, if someone leaves you now, you don't have to necessarily get into another relationship right after. You should actually chill and discover yourself, know the kind of person that you are. I mean, I'm talking out of experience here. Like, this is something that is very, like, means a lot to me. I don't like it when I see people that are hurting because I've been hurt, right? And then I like talking to people about things like this because I know it's true. I know you're not just making up excuses. I know you actually fear being alone, but then you have to work on it. You have to discover yourself. You have to find yourself. Do something to distract you completely from relationship. Get into something. I mean, like, learn a trade, do something else, do something that makes you happy. If being with family makes you happy, then be with family most of the time. Like, just do something else, right? One thing I want to say is that if you're using any excuse to be with somebody, then that is a big sign of a bad relationship. If you have to make up an excuse to be with somebody, that is definitely like a bad, bad relationship. Like, for example, if you're like, oh, I'm in this relationship with this person because he's nice to me, or I'm in this relationship with this person because, oh, he's a fine boy, or she's a fine girl, her body banging though, all those kind of things. Like, if you have to make up an excuse to be with somebody, sometimes, like, you have to like sit down and think about this person that you supposedly like or maybe even love. You have to sit down and think about it. Oh, does my heart yearn for this person? Do I really care about this person this much that I want to commit to this thing we have? Like, you have to think, and you have to. But if you have to now tell yourself, oh, he's rich, or she's this. If you have to make up an excuse, then that is the number one sign that you're probably in a bad relationship. So, for 2 seconds, just think about like whatever relationship you're in right now and ask yourself, am I really in a bad relationship? Brandy circulars. Oh yeah, think. Okay. that's like, I feel like that's enough time to actually think. Well, it's not, but after the video, you can think if, like, yeah, basically. So, yeah, let me see. What else do I have to say? Reasons that you're probably still in a bad relationship or you cannot leave are like, you felt bad saying no. Ha, this is something I have seen. This is something I have heard. This is something like my close friends have been through. This is something I personally have been through. I felt bad saying no. I mean, you cannot compromise your own happiness for the sake of another person. You felt bad saying no, and if you say no, what's going to happen? Let your yeah be yeah and your no be no, to be honest. Let your yes be yes and your no be no. If you know you don't want it, if you know you're not ready, if you know this is not what you want, don't bother going into it. Because you're just going to leave at the end of the day and it's not going to be worth it. I mean, you've wasted emotions. Like, this is something people have to understand, something I myself have to understand. If you do not want something, you don't have to go into it. You don't have to force yourself into anything. You don't have to. You don't have to. Because, like, okay, I'm scared to say no. Like, what is so hard? I mean, I'm not, honestly, some people cannot turn people down, which is actually very hard. It's actually hard to turn someone down. But then think about it. In the short run, everything is going to come crumbling down. You're going to be hurting. Like, because you might probably now see someone that you actually care about more, and then since you're already in one relationship, you might lose the other person. So you have to take your time. There's nothing to rush. There's no reason to rush. There's nothing to rush into. Another reason why you might be in a bad relationship is because you don't want to be the only single friend. This is just basically dating someone just for the sake of dating. I mean, what, like, it's not a compulsory thing to be in a relationship. Like, it's not compulsory, right? Even if you're the only single friend, I mean, I kind of understand the fact that, okay, everyone around you is in a relationship. Like, now I'm in Canada and everything, and then we have, like, now it's cold and everything, and then this is like cuddling season, cuddle bunny, everything. But then, being the only single person, please get something that makes you happy as well. This is another situation of getting something that makes you happy. If it's Netflix, if it's anything, sit down and watch it by yourself. Roku TV and chill by yourself, basically. So, like, yeah, you don't want to be the only single friend. I mean, this is something a whole lot of people are going through. Like, yes, everyone around you is in a relationship, but then, me personally, I have people around me that are in bad relationships. If you're not like, oh, you want to go into a relationship, what if your relationship is more than those ones? Like, you cannot be like comparing yourself to like all these Instagram people you're seeing, all these people on Instagram. I mean, relationship goes this, relationship goes that. You never. So you cannot base your relationship on like Instagram relationship goals, you cannot base your relationship on Instagram relationship goals, this and that kind of thing. Like, you don't know what's happening to those people, like, behind curtains, behind the camera, like, everything. You do not know what they're going through. So, like, don't be like, I want relationship goal. If you go and meet carry another person's relationship goal, and like, you don't know whether the guy is using her to do boxing or she's using the guy to do boxing. You don't know. And we don't want that for ourselves now, do we? Another reason why people get into, like, terrible relationships is because they're trying to get over someone else. Do not ever go into anything. Or, like, don't ever get into a relationship because they're trying to get over someone else or because they're trying to make another person jealous. That means that every little thing the person you're with now is doing to you or is going to do to you, you get irritated so easily and start comparing that person to your other partner. It's not going to work, like, will it work at all? Like, don't ever do it. Like, do not say, okay, because this person hurts me, I want to now, like, date the person's sister or something like that. I want to now be with the person's dad. You don't know how far people can go in this 21st century. Or, like, don't ever use another person as a rebound. Because you are done with a past relationship, you now actually start dating someone else just so you can get over that person. You're going to be hurting every day because your heart is going to be with your ex. You will never have peace with the person you're with right now. Like, you don't do it because it won't work. The relationship is just going to keep going down the drain. You guys are going to have arguments all the time, and this is not like you will not have a healthy relationship, basically, if you're using another person as a rebound. So do not do it. And then, to make someone else other than yourself happy, do not ever go into a relationship just to make someone else happy. Like African parents, like when you get to a certain age, they start pressurizing you. Okay, you need to get married, you need to get married, you need to do this, you need to do that. Like if you feel you're not ready, if you feel you're not ready, don't go into a relationship to make someone else happy, because you're going to be hurt. This is just a waste of emotion, because that you might get into a wrong, like the wrong kind of relationship. Your partner can be cheating on you and stuff like that. Don't do it, because they are not going to be happy. And I'm telling you these things because, like, I actually really do care. This is something that is very, like, this is something that is very sensitive to me. This is a sensitive topic to me. Like, do not go into a relationship because you're trying to make someone else happy. It might not be your parents, it might be your friend. Okay, let's say this boy has been chasing you for a very long time, and then you have been meeting your friends, please help me talk to her, and just so you can make your friends happy, you actually go into that relationship. If you do not care about somebody, don't bother, because you will not give the person enough attention. You will not, the person will just be like, it will just be like wasted effort, because every single thing that person is saying to you, you will not, it will not be agreeing with your ears at all. Like, it's not, you will not be happy with the person, basically. And then you end up having to end the relationship. This is like let's say 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 months, even a year wasted. Like, you shouldn't bother wasting your time with someone you do not care about. Like, it's just sad. It's just sad to know that you are actually with someone that you don't care about, because then you'll be, person calls you, it's like you don't even want to talk to the person. Person texts you, you'll be airing the person anyhow, just like that kind of thing. And then if any little opportunity you get to leave, you're actually going to leave. That's the thing. You're actually going to leave, because you're not loving the person for who they are. You're not loving the person because of what they what you see in them. You're just loving the person because, okay, you're trying to make someone else happy. You're not even loving the person, you're just wasting the person's time. Like, do not waste people's time. Like, don't waste people's time. Don't lead people on, because it's actually very hurtful. You don't know how much that person has sacrificed for you, and then you cannot pay back sacrifice, because it's not just money, it's attention, it's love. There's no way you can pay it back, and you end up like hurting the person really, really bad. So don't bother going into it. Not knowing that you now go into it and now be looking for a way to end it. It won't work. And then last but not least, do not go into a relationship because you are looking for attention. Oh my god. This one is very rampant. Like, everybody does it these days. Like, because you need attention, or because you just want to do like Snapchat love or Instagram love or this and that. It's not worth it, because all you're looking for, all you're searching for from the person is attention. Last but not least, I don't understand why people say, oh, we're not dating, it's just a thing. I don't want to add a tag, or you guys are not sure dating is really what you want to go into. But I mean, you can still get hurt in a thing. You still pass emotions in a thing. So there is no point of like having that thing part. If you guys are not actually getting to know each other, and you're just acting like you're in a relationship, but without the title. Does this make sense to you? Like, you get my point? So basically, you can still get hurt in a thing. Don't go into a thing if you're not willing to actually further that thing with that person. Do you get me? I'm sure you get me. So we have come to the end of like the video today. If you have any problems, or if you want to talk to me about anything, like relating to anything, not just relationships, but maybe like mainly relationships, like anything at all that you want to talk to me about, like follow my Twitter. You can DM me on Twitter, join the Snapchat family, and add me on Instagram. You can talk to me on any of those like social media platforms. I'll leave like all my details. Thank you so much for watching this video today. I love you guys so much. And join me on my next video, which is like most definitely going to be a vlog with my dad. Bye.
Shut the fuck up.
Nah. Thank you, baby.